Now, we were just talking to the gardeners, and the growing season's still ongoing, and that means we still have some problems with allergies. And your allergy report just in today from down the highway in Rochester. Dr. Donald Pulver says we still have low levels of ragweed pollen. So that's the issue if you're still sneezing, if you suffer from that ailment. 63 degrees at the airport right now. It is 65 degrees in downtown Syracuse. And you'll see the temperature a little bit warmer towards Westmoreland right now at 69 degrees, and it's 68 in Rome. Temperatures will be comfortable for the overnight, but above average. Typical temperatures would be in the lower 40s. We'll be in the upper 50s, folks. And it's not even showing up on the radar because it's just a mist, but enough that I am getting wet out here without this umbrella, hence holding it. Here's Fossil Service Experts live triple Doppler radar. We've got steadier light showers here and rainfall moving to the east in Otsego County near the Cooperstown area, also near Old Forge in Herkimer County, maybe eastern sections of Lewis County and northeastern Oneida County as well. Here's what you need to know looking forward for the next couple of days. Overnight tonight, the drizzle, mist, clouds, and fog linger. That fog could be the biggest problem tonight, as it could be dense. Clearing for tomorrow. So if you're looking for the sunshine, you might have to hunt for a while early on, but by the afternoon, really starting to enforce itself, it'll be a pleasant day as well. Then we're cooler, more seasonal towards midweek as a new system arrives. We also turn wet. Lots of clouds for tonight, not much clearing, but any clearing will lead to some fog, and there'll be a little rain at times, but it's very light, a mist or some drizzle. Even some patchy mist in the morning, but otherwise we're quiet tomorrow, mostly cloudy, and then brightening as we get towards midday, partial sunshine and even further clearing to finish the day with sun and clouds. That should get our temperature into the lower 70s, 10 degrees above average, before clouds increase late tomorrow night and then going into Wednesday morning, maybe a peak of sun early on, but there is moisture waiting out to the west, and towards late morning, some areas midday, we begin to get some light rain showers. It looks like more to our south and southwest of Syracuse, could be mainly dry north and northeast, so a close call for Wednesday. 58 degrees the call for tonight. We've got that mist drizzle out there and some areas of dense fog forming. So temperatures above average tonight as well as tomorrow. Very pleasant, starting off mostly cloudy, but a clearing. We'll find that increasing sunshine for the afternoon and the wind refreshing at 3 to 15 miles per hour. Here's the 7-day forecast, not 17. Showers will be developing. They should be on the light side on Wednesday. 61, 63 degrees Thursday with an early shower. Then we're back into the 70s for a trio days. Some showers towards Friday, late day and evening. An isolated shower north of Syracuse on Saturday. It's mostly dry. And then scattered showers and storms Sunday, mostly during the late afternoon. And those temperatures way above average this weekend. Right now in Syracuse, the